Mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It is about understanding. So let's learn and enjoy mathematics. Our lesson is about introduction to chords and arcs of a circle. What are the objectives of the chords and arcs of a circle? First, we will define chords and arcs of a circle. Second, we will recognize the chords and arcs of a circle. And at the third one, we will identify the chords and arcs of a circle. Let us identify what is the circle. Circle is a set of points equidistant from a given point called the center of the circle. So this is an example of the circle. The symbol for the circle is this one, circle C. What is chord? A chord is a segment whose two endpoints are on the circle. So it means may linya at yung dalawang endpoint nasa circle. So let us name all the chord. So the chords are segment AB or segment BA. Other chords is segment CD and segment DC. The third one is segment CF or segment FC. And then the last one, segment BE or segment EB. So what is radius? A radius is the distance from the center to any point in a circle, half the measurement of the diameter. So let us name the radius. So the radius is segment AC or segment CA. How about the diameter? A chord that passes through the center of the circle. So it is also known as the longest chord. So tulad ng chord, meron siyang two endpoints, but then kailangan dumaan siya sa center of the circle. So let us name of the diameter. So line segment or segment BC or segment CB. Example, in the figure, let us identify the chords, the radii, and diameters. So let us identify. So the chords are segment AB or segment BA. Other chords are segment CE or segment EC. Another chord is segment BF and then segment FB. Let us identify the radii. So meron tayong tatlong radii. So segment BG or segment GB. Other radius is segment GF or segment FG. Another radius is segment GD or segment DG. How about the diameter? The diameter is segment BF or segment FB. So what is an arc? An arc is a portion of a circle that consists of two endpoints. So let us name the arc. So that is arc AB. So this is arc AB. The symbol for the arc is this one. There are three types of arcs. The first is the major arc, and the major arc is more than 180 degrees. So let us name the major arc. Use the three letters. So the major arc is arc B, C, A. So ito yun. The second types of arc is minor arc. Minor arc is less than 180 degrees. So always use two letters to identify the minor arc. So the minor arc is arc AB. The third types of arc is semicircle. Semicircle equals to 180 degrees. Use three letters to identify the semicircle. So the semicircle is semicircle arc CEA. Or pwede rin namang arc ABC. Example, let us identify the part of the circle based in the given illustration. Let us identify the minor arcs, the major arcs, and the semicircle. So the minor arc is arc AB, also arc BC, arc CD, and then arc DA. How about the major arc? Let us identify the different major arcs. So that is more than 180 degrees. So that is arc B, DA. So this is B, DA. Another is B, C, and then A. Also C, D, B. And then C, D, A. Another major arc is D, A, C. And then D, B, C. The another major arc also is A, C, D. And then the last one is A, B, D. How about the semicircle? So let us identify the semicircle. So that is D, A, B, and B, C, D. Another example, let us identify the part of the circle based in the given illustration. So let us identify what is segment CD. So this is segment CD. So what is the value of segment CD? So CD is considered as the chord because two endpoints. How about AE? AE is the radius. How about BC? So ito yung BC. So BC, that is the diameter because dumaan siya sa center of the circle. How about EB? EB is also a chord. How about sa arc length or arc CE? So arc CE is the minor arc. Let us practice what you have learned about the chords and arcs of a circle. Instruction, given the circle, name the following parts of the circle. Be sure to use proper notation. Provide your answers in the comment section. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.